Welcome. We are about to begin our noon hour fusion fitness workout. So we're going to let people load into class today and get ready to go. So good afternoon, everyone. I'm Helen. For those of you who are just starting out with me, of course, you know who I am because you've been following me. But anyway, I always feel rude not introducing myself before our class starts. So today we have about a 40-45 minute workout. It's a total body workout. We are going to hit all the major muscle groups of the body as we work through it today. It is all body weight, so you don't need any equipment. The only thing that you might want to have is a yoga mat, right? So if you have a yoga mat, that is helpful because it's just more comfortable to work out in. If you have a fitness mat, just know that sometimes the fitness mats are a little bit slippery on the floor when we do this kind of workout. The other thing is you can wear shoes for this workout. I'm going to go bare feet, and it's just a weird thing. I feel like I can't wear running shoes in my living room. I don't know why, but it just feels wrong for me. So I'm not going to wear any running shoes, but you could wear running shoes for this workout. So this could be running shoes or bare feet. So if you're better off in shoes, please put your shoes on for this workout. It does not need to be barefoot. We are going to do some jumping. So if you are sensitive to bare feet and jumping, then definitely put your shoes on for this workout. Anyway, we are about to begin. So we've got about a minute to make sure that everybody gets started. I'm hoping that you're having a fantastic week. And I just had that realization before we started is that tomorrow is Good Friday. It is the long weekend, the Easter long weekend, which just kind of blows me away a little bit. For the Easter long weekend, I will be doing a class on Friday. So tomorrow I am going to do a stretch class because I think after a whole week, and it's a holiday, we should do a stretch. Now, for those of you who follow me for stretch, I do a little different take on stretch. I'm going to do some active release and stretch. So if you have a foam roller or a massage ball, we'll use that as well tomorrow in our stretch, just to give us a little bit more. If you don't have any of that equipment at home, don't worry. You can do the full stretch without any of the equipment. So that's tomorrow's class at noon is a stretch. Then we'll do a Pilates class on Saturday, and Sunday is a day of rest. So a day with your family, whoever your family is in your confinement of your home, right? So you kind of do your own little Easter event in your homes. Okay, so let's get started on our workout. It is exactly 12 o'clock, and I want to make sure that we get this full workout in. So who's in today? Oh, I see some people have come back from yesterday's class. So how'd you feel after yesterday? Any stiff muscles? I'm a little bit stiff, I'm going to tell you, for sure. I got a little bit of soreness. Joanne, great to have you back. Wendy, great to see you again. Again, some of you, I have no idea. Yes, so some of you come to my fascial flex class at the academy when I teach. So yes, tomorrow is a fascial flex class. So yay, right? We're going to get into that fascial system and really stretch it out and release some of the tension in our body. Okay, so let's get started and make it happen. I'm going to go song by song. Beginning a song, we start something. The end of the song, we're done it. So just in case you are into something like push-ups and you're like, is it ever going to be over? It will be over at the end of the song. So you can look forward to that. So we're going to warm it up. Let me turn on the music, and we are in. All right, so let's bring your feet comfortable distance apart for you. Maybe shoulder width, maybe a little bit wider, maybe parallel, maybe slightly turned up. It is your comfortable stance. If you were to stand strong and stable, where would that be? Take a deep breath. Inhale, raise up. Exhale, take the tension away. Inhale, raise up. Exhale, let it go. So breath is our foundation to everything. So you want to get some nice deep breathing going right now. Good. One more. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, and shake it out. Reach up overhead, and now come down, touch the mat. All right, so you're coming back into the hips. Reach up, full reach. Down nice and slow. Full reach up. Nice and slow down. We're going to pick up the tempo. Are you ready? Here we go. We're taking it up. And touch, and lift, and touch. Yes, we're just trying to elevate the heart rate, elevate your breathing rate, and get the body warm and ready for the work. Two more, one more. Take it down to the bottom and hold. Right arm reaches. Oh, come down, left arm reaches. Come down, reach up, let's do that again. Come down, right arm reaches. And down, left arm reaches. And down, and up. Roll the shoulders. How does it feel? Yeah, now make it a little bit bigger. Open up the elbows. And then start to create a circle. Open up through the entire shoulder girdle. For four, three, two, one. Swing the arms up and back. Good. Breathe through it. Add the legs. Little swing. Good. Two more right here. One more. Now we're going to alternate. So you're going to take it right, left. You got a little pulse in the legs. If you're feeling like, hey, I feel a little uncoordinated there, you just do what you do. You do you, right? That's the general theme of these workouts. You do you, whatever feels right. One more. Each arm. Good. Bring the arms out, open, and rotate. Right. Good. So one way, the other way. So just creating a little rotation through the torso, but we're keeping the legs stable. So we get the ribs to move, and then we're gonna add the whole body. One more. Good. Come center, open up. Now turn out, bend your knees. And now rotate, rotate. So notice if there's tension in your back, nice and easy, we're gonna add the legs. Here we go. From the foot, lift and rotate, lift and rotate. So the whole body rotates. So for my golfers out there, right, if you are a golfer, you always swing from the foot through the pelvis, through the upper body. Four, three, two, one. Take a deep breath. Inhale, nice wide stance. Exhale, sweep down. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, sweep down. Inhale, come all the way up. Side bend. Inhale up. Exhale over. Inhale up. Open it up. And that's your warm up. Ready to go. Let's come into our squat series. Okay, so this is going to be a progressive squat. We're going to start with parallel squats. We're going to add on, and add on, and have fun with it for a full song. Yeah? All right. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. Start slow. Four, three, two, and one. So you got four counts each direction. Take it down. Nice and slow. Look at your alignment. Now you want to have knees and toes aligned. What do we mean by that? Right? So the direction of the toes is the direction the knees bend. Right? So direction of the toes, direction of the knee bend. Good. Let's pick it up. Take it down. Down and up. Down and up. So now, a little bit more heart raising, right? But we're just beginning. Four more. For four and up. Three. Now you're going to find in this set, not only are you going to get your legs working out, but you're going to get your heart rate. We're going to add alternate knee. Left knee comes up. Right knee comes up. Down. Lift. Down. And lift. So you're shifting your weight over top of that supporting leg. So far, so good. We're going to take that into a kick. So you're going up, lift, kick, in. I lost my balance. Lift, kick, in. Lift, kick, in. Down. Lift. Did anybody else lose your balance when you did that? Go up, out, in. I always say to be everybody, it's like we're all human, right? Lift, out, in, right? So you do the best you can. That. So you go up, kick, in, down. Up, kick, in, down. I lost it again. Good. One more. Up, kick, in, and hold. Good. Now pulse at the bottom. You lift it up and lower. So lift up about 3 inches. 3 inches, control down. 3 inches, control down. So for my downhill skiers, think you're going over the moguls. Up and over, up and over. So the question is, can we do the whole series again from the top? Yeah, four, three, two, hold the bottom. Yes. Stand up, four counts down. Four, three, two, and up. Nice and slow. Now we got a little bit more fatigue this second time through, right? We're feeling a little bit more. And up, pick up the tempo, down two, one, two, up two, one, two. So we just picked it up a little bit. We're gonna pick it up a little bit more, right, as we add that leg lift. Ready? down and up. So we go into tempo that you feel like you can get that range of motion. Are we ready to add the alternate knee lift? For 4, 3, 2, here we go. Lift, lower, up, lower, lift, lower. So alternate knee lifts. We're gonna add that balance exercise. And when we add the balance exercise, we're gonna slow it down. Good, 2 more. 1 more. Good. Balance. Lift, kick, in, down. Up, out, finding balance. I am struggling with balance today. Well, there you go. Who knew? Lift, kick, in, down. Whew. I gotta focus. I can't talk to you right now. Boom. Keep it going. One more. Lift, out, down, pulse. Whew. Lift it up. So you're lifting up and over, up and over. How's the second round feeling? Good. 4, 3, 2, hold. And stand up. Oh, tap it out. Tap it out. Whew, I felt that. Okay, definitely challenged on balance today, I'm telling you. Maybe I'm doing too many workouts. Let's come to the floor. Let's come up to the end of your mat. All right, take a nice deep breath. Inhale, raise up. Hip hinge forward, long spine. Hands to your shins. Inhale, lengthen your spine. So really actively engage your core. Exhale, float down. Walk along your mat and come to plank. Good. So now in plank, I'm gonna create a little series of movements. Little series of movements. Okay. So you can be toes or knees, your choice. Take your feet a little bit wider so you're more stable. Take your right arm, reach it forward. Lower, reach it side. Lower, rotate, tap your shoulder, and down. Let's try the other side. Reach it forward, lower, side, lower, rotate, tap your shoulder, and down. Here we go. Reach, lower, side, lower, open, tap your shoulder, and down. You got this. Forward, touch, side, touch. Open, shoulder, down. Reach. Now you go at your tempo. Whoops, I added a new move in there. Out, in, and tap. Front. Whew. 2 more rounds. Reach, side. 1 more. Got it. Go for it. Touch. Small break. Whew. Set of push-ups, right? Set of push-ups. Yeah, yeah. Now we're gonna go wider than your mat. Bring your feet wide as your mat, lower down. So elbows are wide. Lift it up, chest in, lift up, breathe. Here we go, from the bottom. Push, lower. Now, you can always go to your knees, but the arms are super wide. Why? I want you to train your back muscles. All right, so the elbows are wide. We're out wide. Every time you go down, you should feel all the muscles across your back working. All right, so as you lower, it's back. As you push up, it's front. So chest and shoulder, then the back of the shoulder and the upper back. For 4, 3, 2, 1, hold, walk your hands in underneath your shoulders, lift your hips up, hold back. Good. So we're gonna come forward to plank, lift your right leg, hold. Down dog, forward, left leg, hold. Lower back, lift and plank. So we rock between our down dog and our perfect plank. Now you can keep both feet down or keep alternating. Really set those shoulders in strong in the plank. Almost there. One more. Other leg. Hold your plank. Lower. Hug your arms in. Lower all the way down. Whew. Here we are on the floor. Back extensions. Take your feet about as wide as your mat or slightly wider. One hand crosses on top of the other. Tuck your chin. Start with the elbows wide. Lift, reach, in, and lower. Lift, reach, in, lower. Good. So you reach out into a V. So the arms go out, you stay high, then you lower. So you lift, extend, in, and lower. Now, I know your face is down, looking at the floor of the mat. So keep that and just listen for these cues. Activate your legs by engaging your quadricep muscles, the front of the thigh, to lift the kneecaps up, right? So the legs are active. When the legs are active, it helps to support your low back. Keep that. Now, as you keep that, press the front of your pelvis down. So the front of the pelvis presses down towards the floor. Good. Keep the legs active and the front of the pelvis down. Good. Hold that. Now, imagine from the base of your pelvic floor all the way up to your navel, your belly button, you're gonna lift up like a girdle. Lift, keep going everybody, keep going. Two more. One more. Now go out and hold. Lift your legs, lift your arms, hold, breathe, breathe. Four, three, two, one. Some of you saw that when your dog's visiting. Curl your toes under. Push up. Whew. Okay, hold, hold, hold. Walk one knee in, other knee in. Now stabilize and hold. Float your knees up. Float your knees up. Good. Touch your right leg back. Right and in. Left and in. Right and in. At any time, you can bring your knees to the ground. But for now, you are not. You are just tapping. I like the way you work it, right? Keep it working. Soft elbows, strong spines, strong core. Slightly tuck your chin, crown of the head reaching forward for four. In, three, in, two, one more. Good, knees come down, roll up. Good, now from here, lean back. What? And then come up. Lean back. You're gonna feel all of the anterior muscles having to work. So slightly tuck your chin. Good. Reach your arms forward. Whew. Hold. Hold. Now you lean back to where you can. Where's the best place for you to lean to? Inhale, lift up. Exhale, go back. Inhale up. Exhale, lean back. Inhale up. One more time, now hold. Open it out and in. As out and in. Lean back to where it's comfortable, doable for you, but challenging. Challenging yourself right here. Oh, right. Good. Open, overhead. Bring yourself forward. Float your knees back up. Float your knees back up. And tap. One leg. The other leg. Almost done. Almost done. Woo-wee. We're going to end where we started this song. We're going to end where we started the song. Four, three, two, one. Hold it in. Lift the hips up. Come to your down dog. Walk yourself forward. Lower yourself down. Woo. Reach the legs out. Hands to your head. Lift. Reach, in, lower. Huh. Right? So we're ending where we finished. Or we ending where we started. Ending where we started. Keep it going, everybody. Almost there. Whew. Two more repetitions. One more. This time, come up, hold. Legs lift, arms reach. Find that length. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, hands in, curl your toes under. Firm your core, draw the elbows back, push up. Hold your plank. Lift your hips up, downward facing dog. Walk out your feet. Finish it up before we start our next series. All right, so next series is the bar series. All right, so last 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring your heels up, lift your hands, jump or step in. Exhale, fold forward. Lengthen through the spine, shake out the head, the shoulders, all the way to standing. And then open it up. All right, so now let's bring your feet out to a nice wide stance. So externally rotate from your hips. So from the hip, you're gonna turn out from the toe to the toes, and then you're gonna lower yourself down and just find the right distance between your feet. Now, what is the right distance? Depending on how far you can go down vertically, your shin bones create a vertical line. All right, so your vertical line in the shins. That is your end point. So where are you in your end point? Then stand up from there. All right, arms come out, shoulders relax. We're gonna lower down, lift your right heel, left heel, stand up. That's where we start. Left heel, right heel, stand up. So we just start with one foot, the other foot, stand up. Next time you go down, the other leg leads. 1, 2, stand up. That's all we do for now. And you're like, okay, not so bad, not so bad. But it sneaks up on you. It does, right? It sneaks up on you. Now really think about, while we're not rushing here, that your technique. Can you keep your body vertical, right? And what I mean by that is the head is directly over top of the pelvis. Right, the pelvis is below you. Your low back has this natural curve, right? Good. And stand up. Let's come down. Right heel only. Right, right. Now, as the right leg's doing that, the arms are going to go overhead, front, and open. Overhead, front, and open. A little coordination, right? Your heels just going up and down while the arms are doing some weird thing. Right? Hold it here. Now pulse. Lift out of the leg. Lift out of the joints. All right, so if you were training with me yesterday for the bar class, right, my philosophy is do not press into the joint, lift out of it. So engage the muscle out of the joint when you pulse. Lift 4, 3, 2, hold, heel down, stand up, small break. Come back down. Left heel goes up and down, a little coordination, right? Overhead, forward, open, but keep the heel lifting and lowering. All right, so coordination, because dance requires coordination. Heel goes up and down, arms and hold. Now press. Cool. Right? Are you feeling something? Just checking in with you, seeing who else arrived today. All right. Janine, nice to have you here. All right. Lewis, have nice to have you here again. Keep it working. Where are we? 2, 1, heel down, stand up. Good, now from there, walk your feet in a little closer. You're gonna press and up. So we're halfway between that full jump out and that full jump in, okay? So we go 3, 2, 1, out. 3, 2, 1, halfway. 3, 2, 1, out. 3, 2, 1, halfway. 3, 2, 1, out. 3, 2, 1, halfway. 3, 2, 1, and hold. Inhale. Come up. Nice. Turn your toes in. Inhale, up. Exhale, hip hinge, forward bend. Let the tension go to your neck, your shoulders. We have a push-up plank series. Walk your hands forward. Good. Tricep push-up to begin with. Feet are wide, or knees can come down. Hug it in, push it up. Lower, push. Now remember, you don't need to be a hero in your living room, right? You do what you can do. If you do two reps and you take a break and then you do two more again, take a break, that's awesome. You just want to accumulate the effort. Accumulate the effort. One more. And then lift up, press back. Oh. Now some of you did this with me the other day. Now we're going for it. Walk your feet in underneath you. Right leg up. Step your right hand out, or right foot out to a lunge. Good, now take your left hand, turn it out so you can shift your weight onto it. So we're leaning into the side. You should already feel your core working. You're gonna pick up that back leg, reach this arm up, lift in, touch back, in, touch back, in, pull up through the center of your body. One more, this time thread through, sit down. Right, make sure your hand is in a good place for your shoulder to lift up. Good, now, one arm tricep dip. Now if you're saying, you know what, too much. Hips down, tricep dip here, right? Yeah, you can keep your hips down and do it. Two more. One more. Thread the leg back, hand comes down. Reset your hands. Okay, lift up, step back, downward facing dog. Woo. Opposite leg up, step forward to a lunge, wide position, set up your opposite hand that you can lean into it. Hand up, pull in, go back, in, back. I'm going to show you sideways so you can see what's happening. Good. In, lunge, in, lunge. It's like you do a tuck and then a reach. Reach. Try and stay light. Core controls this. Two more. One more. Thread the leg through and sit down. Adjust his hand for tricep push-ups. Lift up, lower, lift, lower, lift. Remember you have the option to sit down. I didn't say this was going to be easy, did I? No. Did not say that. It's a total body workout. Four more. Three more, two more, one, lift, thread, hands place into your shoulder position, lift up, step back, down dog. Good, lift your heels, bend your knees, lift your hands, walk your feet to your hands, exhale, forward bend. Inhale, all the way up, exhale. And open. So we have a lunge set. Lunge set. So we're going to do what's called transverse lunge. No, lateral lunge. Lateral lunge first. Lateral lunge first. Hey, Coop. Okay, so you're going to take your left leg, step it out to the side, right where my dog is, and sit. And up, sit, lift. Hopefully he'll get bored soon, and he will leave. I can't talk to him though, because then he'll stay. So I'm going to talk to you instead. Keep going. I told you he'd get bored. He's bored. He's like, seriously, she is boring. So you're stepping out. Now you step out, the leg you're stepping away from is straight. The opposite leg is bending. Land softly two more times. One more time. And this time go out, stay out. So now, one leg is bent, one leg is straight. Hips are back. Lift halfway, sit. Lift, sit. Good. Now, come up onto the toe of the supporting of the straight leg. Up onto the toe, so you get a little bit more range of motion. Sit the hips way back, and then roll up onto the toe, sit back. Now hold. Small lift up, just about an inch. Up, 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 stay there. You gotta tell me, is it working? Hey, how are you doing? Got more people that joined us. Laura, great that you're here. If you're jumping in just now, come on in. We're about halfway through the workout, but halfway is better than nothing, right? Good, for 4, 3, 2, 1, stand up. Whew. Release your hips. Okay, make sure you got room to go the other way. Step out, lower down, and up. Now, what's really important about lateral lunges is the weight goes back into your hips. So I'm going to show you sideways. Your weight goes back. So you're sitting into that large muscle, the glute. This is the controller, right there. Right, that pushes you out, that pulls you back in. Now on the way in, also think about the inner thigh closing the legs. So we activate the outside of the leg, the inside of the leg. That's why I love this exercise. Most of us are weaker sideways than we are forward and back. So if you're finding it challenging, sometimes it is. Two more. One more. Next one, go back. Now make sure your weight is out of the knee and back in the hips. Good, from here, we lift. But as we lift, you're gonna roll onto the ball of the foot, heel of the foot, of that straight leg. What? Why? Because it's gonna give you a little more range of motion. Lift, push, lift, push. Two more, one more. Now stay there. Very small lift, very small lift. You could do an isometric hold or this very small lift. You choose isometric hold or small lift. Keep it working. Nice work for 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on up and walk it out. Oh, so good, so good. So let's do a little yoga. Right, come to the end of the mat. Take a deep breath, inhale, raise up. Exhale, hinge forward. Walk your hands forward. Good, lower down all the way. Point your toes away, inhale, extend. Exhale, come down. Curl your toes under, push yourself up, go back. Right leg lifts, step out to the outside of your right hand. Whew, create a little flow. Open and rotate. Breathe. Hand comes down, step back, downward facing dog. Opposite leg lifts. Good, step forward, lunge. Rotate. Come back down. Step up, downward dog. Breathing into it, breathing out of it. Lift your heels, bend your knees, lower down to the mat, and then come to seated. Okay, so we've got our seated series, our core series coming up. So if you worked out with me last week, you know we were working on something. Yeah, we were. So if you're new, we'll break it down, and then we're gonna go for it. Legs out, inhale here, exhale, roll. All right, roll. Hands can be behind your thighs if you like, all the way back. Whew. Tuck the chin, roll up. So let's just get the core active. Nice, slow control. Control it all the way through the range of motion. You almost want to feel like the mat is like a Velcro strip. And when you roll up, you're pulling each part of your spine away from the strip. And then when you're going down, you're trying to put each part of the spine on that strip. And now, if you ever try to put Velcro together, you know you gotta be very, very precise. Otherwise, it misaligns. So keep it going. All right, lie back. All right, here we go. Bend the leg closest to the camera for me. Okay, arms go up. Inhale, exhale, curl up. Good, lower down. Curl up. So now with the bent leg, it feels a little bit different, but we're going to add rotation. Curl up. Place the hands on the ground. Lift, roll back. Up, place the hands on the ground. Lift, rotate back. Now we're going to go the opposite way. Curl up, place the hands on the ground. Lift, roll back. So you're going to go up, you're going to rotate towards a straight leg. Up and lower down. Good? Good again. All right, this is just preparation stuff. I'm telling you, just preparation. Come all the way down, stretch it out. Okay, so opposite leg, bends. Yeah, we're doing more than one song for this one. Inhale, come all the way up. Lift, rotate towards the bent knee. Oh, he's now licking the sweat off of me. That's serious. Okay, lift up. Bye, Cooper. Go away. Go away, honey. I love you, but not right now. Okay, lift, rotate, reach, and lower. Lift, rotate, reach. Now you're going to go to the straight leg. Lift, rotate, go lie down, go lie down, go lie down, go lie down. Good boy, you stay there. Okay, keep it going to the straight leg. Inhale, good, and rest. Leg straight. Okay, so leg straight. Okay, so now, here we go, roll back again. Here's the fun part. Okay, the leg closest to the camera, stay straight, bend the back leg. Okay, curl up, reach up. Hands come to the floor, you lift this leg up. Okay, all good? And now we're gonna switch. You're gonna bring this leg through and switch. And then you come back and you sit down and you roll back. What? Curl up, hands come down, lift, switch, switch, come down, roll back. All right, you go at your time. Boom, boom. One more on this leg. Lift. Are you having a little bit of fun with it? Anybody taking out furniture right now? It's like, I'm just kicking things around the house and roll back. Oh, small break. Heart rate maybe is elevated. Switch legs. I'm going to turn around so my butt is not to you. Okay. Good. Roll up. Hands down. Lift up. Switch through, switch through, sit, roll back. Whew, that's heart raising, yeah? Lift, switch, switch, sit, roll back. Two more. Lift, up, through, through, down, roll back. One more. Lift, ha. Up, switch, switch, sit, roll back, rest. Go lie down, lie down, go lie down, go lie down. All right, here we go. Everybody, bend your knees. Lie down, right there, lie down, lie down. Good boy. Okay, hands behind your head. Curl and lower. Curl and lower. Curl. He is not giving up. Cooper, lie down. Go. Lie down. Lie down. Good boy, lie down. Keep curling, everybody. Stay. Stay, be good boy. Okay? He's looking at me like, what? Keep going. Good, now come up. Hold. One leg up, the other leg up. Curl and lower. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, inhale. It's because it was his birthday yesterday. He thinks he needs all the attention. Keep going. Shh. Shh. Now stay here. Legs apart. Flex your feet. Have about shoulder distance between your legs. Rotate one way, the other way. We finish it. We finish it. Now, feet are apart. The reason why is when the legs are together, you have more stability. When the legs are apart, you've got to work a little harder for stability. Yeah? 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come to the center. Now, curl the ribs in towards your pelvis. Legs come together. We press it out.
we come in. Push through the feet, come in. That's the action of the legs. Holding the front rib cage down. One more, come in. Now, action of the arms. Curl up, reach over the knees. Thumbs come to the sides of the head. You reach out, you circle around. You come in, reach, circle. In, reach, circle. Every time you circle around, try and increase the intensity of the contraction of the abdominal wall. So a little bit more intensity, because we're going to bring both of those together. Two more repetitions. One more repetition. Hold. Now turn the toes out, heels in. So your legs are like a frog. You're going to frog out with the legs, squeeze in. Try and keep your heels together. Out with the legs, in. Squeeze the inner thighs together. You can see my legs are shaking. Try and keep those heels connected as you go. Keep the core strong. Hands are supporting your head. Two more. One more. Come in. Good. And now bring the legs in. We reach arms and legs. Finish it. Come in. You can point or flex your toes. Your choice. Double leg stretch from Pilates to finish it up. Inhale. Exhale. If you prefer to have your head down, have the head down, because this is our grand finale. Last four. Last three. Last two. Last one. Hold. 8, 7, 6. 5, 4, 3, 2. Hug it in. Oh, gently rock side to side. How was your workout today? So for those of you who joined us a little bit later, that was a fusion fitness class. Tomorrow we're going to fusion stretch, which is my fascial stretch work. So it's going to be a restorative practice tomorrow at noon. Good. Take your feet to the floor. Arms go out. Inhale here. As you exhale, take both knees over to one side. It doesn't matter which side you go to first. Good. And then if you'd like to intensify the stretch, take the top leg, reach it to your hand, and then pull across your body. Okay, then release the foot from the hand, bend the knee, lift the top leg, then the bottom leg, and hold. Take a breath here in. You exhale, go the opposite way. You can stay there, or hand to foot, reach across, and breathe. Breathing in, breathing out. And then bend that knee. Lift the top leg, lift the bottom leg, cradle your legs and just rock. Oh. Letting tension go. Then coming to the center, use your legs to help you roll up. And then extend the legs out front, fold forward. Inhale halfway up, exhale, come down. So all of the fusion workouts are based on four disciplines: fitness, yoga, Pilates, and dance. And combining all of them in different ways to give you a variety of workouts depending on what your goals are. Good. And then roll up. So today was fusion fitness. A lot of fitness involved in this today. Cross the ankles, one foot in front of the other, doesn't matter which one first. Side bend to one side. Inhale up and over to the side. And just do that two more times. One more time. Good. And release. Switch across the leg, because it's always different when you switch the sides. And let's go. So just four side to side. Last one. And then come to the center. Inhale, raise up. Exhale, take one hand to the floor, organize your legs so you can come up to a kneeling position. In the kneeling position, bring the one leg, the foot, in beside the knee, about a fist distance apart between your knee and your foot, and press the heel down so you stretch the calf. Now, especially for those of you who have been training bare feet for the first time. So the heels down, knee forward, and let your body go into that. Okay. And then bring it up, switch sides. Heel down. From here, find that distance, the heel is down. Then you angle the shin forward so you get a nice stretch through the deep muscles of the calf. Okay, then shift your weight forward into your hands. Pick up that back foot, shift your weight back into your feet, forward bend. Exhale, let the tension go. Move the shoulders, move the head. Soften the knees if the backs of the legs are tight. Good, and then let the hips sit back a little bit so now that you can roll the pelvis, roll through the pelvis all the way up to standing. Take a deep breath. Inhale, open. Exhale, release. One more time. Inhale, open. Exhale, release. And thank you for joining me for your noon hour fusion fitness class. So tomorrow, fusion stretch at noon. So happy that so many of you were able to join me today. All right, some of you were laughing the whole time that Cooper wanted to steal the show today. I don't know, because it was his birthday. That's all I got to say. He thinks it's all about him. Have a great day. Bye.